you should care about politics and people's political positions because they have real consequences. And a person should care about the political positions they hold. So I think one of the problems in modern life is simultaneously people, and today certainly, people are very political and they haven't thought about their politics very much. That's the tribal and not ideological. And because politics deals in the end with the use of force, and if you say more widely, and this is part of what I talked about at the Ayn Rand Con, that it's talking about how properly to subordinate might to right, but the might is the force, and then how do you properly subordinate it? The use of force in society is a really important issue, and it can have, if it's done properly, really positive impacts on your life, and if it's done improperly, can make you a victim in all kinds of ways. So it's a really important issue that one should think about. But that is different than, and I think this is part of what you're asking, how to think about people and their political views. And there, I think there's a lot of variation, and you have to figure out what is going on. So it can be more tribal, but there can be the sort of more passive tribal membership that, I really don't know any better, and this is the kind, so I guess I identify with this group, not that group. But it's not an animating issue for the person. It's, and if you think of the U.S. system, like there's two major parties. So are you in party A or party B? And many people can't even think, well, there's more options than that. Or they might say, well, I'm kind of independent. Or so, but they don't have any real conceptualization of it. So it's not a fundamental classification of people. Often people have not thought very much about it. And it often does not play a central role in the person's life. And that's a crucial issue to think about as well. They might have some political views, but how essential is it to their whole life, the kinds of actions and values they take and are pursuing? What are their other views? Certainly deeper than politics, or what are their moral views? And I know many people who I think are essentially moral people, who I disagree a lot with their politics. But to me, their moral stand is way more fundamental than their political stand. But then to take a different kind of case, you can have someone who, whether they've thought it through or not, are very political, and they're part of political organizations or activist groups. And if they're, what they're doing is fairly detrimental, and an encroachment on people's rights, or helping to grow arbitrary government power. I mean, so there can be a variety of things depending on what group or organization or activism they're doing. That's more significant, but it's also more significant about the person. Like, he's making more of his life about this. And you have to ask, what are the reasons? This is more than just sort of passively going along with things because of these two, that seems more like where I belong, so I would say I'm a Democrat rather than a Republican, or vice versa. Versus, yeah, I made a lot of my life with a lot of energy. It might not be thought, but still a lot of energy into this. That tells you something different about the person. That's a different kind of person. And it tells you, and you have to think about that. And like, is this reasonable what he's doing? Or is it more like he's joined an environmentalist group that's doing like really strangling industry? But then you also have to think, look, what is motivating him there? Is it the strangling of industry, or are there actual things that he thinks he's pursuing some values, the consequences strangling? And there's no simple or shortcut to these kinds of things. These, I think, these are some of the things one has to think about in assessing people.